the Raspberry Pi Pickle. Today we're gonna make this guy a MIDI controller. So let's get started. Hello, my name is Gustavo Silveira, and here in The Nerd Musician I teach, among other things, you to build MIDI controllers. And today we're gonna use this guy, which is the Raspberry Pi Pickle W. You might have heard about the Raspberry Pi, about their famous tiny computers that run Linux, but this one is different. This is not a computer. It is a microcontroller, similar to the Arduinos, the Raspberry Pis, or the Thinsys. And it has a microcontroller, or a brain, made by the Raspberry Pi company called RP2040. So some of you ask me about this, how can I make a MIDI controller with this guy here, and that's what we are going to do today. But first, why choosing the Raspberry Pi Pickle instead of an Arduino or an ESP32 or a Thinsys? First, what they have in common. So none of them are computers, so they don't have an operating system, which make them really, really fast. Also, since they don't have an operating system, you need to hard code them, usually using some C-based language. But with this one is a little bit different, and you see why. So for low-level applications such as robotic, automation, or making MIDI controllers, using a microcontroller like this is very good. They're cheap and very fast. So why would you choose a Raspberry Pi Pickle instead of an Arduino or an ESP32? Well, it depends. So I made a table here showing you the main differences about those microcontrollers, which are my favorite to make MIDI controllers. So one thing about them is that all of them can be MIDI class compliant, so you don't need an extra software like the Hairless MIDI. Let's talk a little bit about speed. The Pro Micro has 16 MHz, the Pi Pico has 133 MHz, the ESP32 240, and the Thinsys 600. Flash memory, the Arduino has 32 kilobytes, the Pi Pico 2 mega, the ESP32 4 mega, and the Thinsys 2 mega. Then digital I/O pins, the Arduino Pro Micro has 12, the Pi Pico 26, the ESP32 34, and the Thinsys 40. Then analog ins and outs, the Pro Micro has 9, the Pico W has 3, the ESP32 34, and the Thinsys 40. And then there's other things that you can look here. I'll leave the link so you can take a look, but you can see some pretty major differences here. The Pro Micro is by far the slowest, but is good enough for 90% of your projects. The Pi Pico has the least number of analog inputs, but it is pretty fast. And also this one also has Wi-Fi. And the Raspberry Pi is super fast, has lots of pins, has Wi-Fi, and has Bluetooth. And the Thinsys also is super fast and has lots of pins. So it seems that the ESP32 and the Thinsys are clearly the winners. They have lots of pins, they are really, really fast. The Arduino, well, it's very well documented, it has a huge community and tons of tutorials. So it's the easier one to use, also very cheap. And what about the Pi Pico? It's very cheap and it can be programmed with MicroPython. And compared to the Arduino, is way faster. Also, this one has Wi-Fi. So it really depends, maybe you already have a Pi Pico with you and you're wondering about making a MIDI controller, so that's what we're gonna do today. For the other boards, I have other tutorials, and also I have a course on how to make MIDI controllers, which I have the link here below. Also, I'd like to thank Elocro, which sent me the Raspberry Pi Advanced Kit, and I'm going to use that kit to make some MIDI controller, which I don't know how it's gonna be yet. So with all that being said, how do we use the Raspberry Pi Pico? And how do we make it into a MIDI controller? So as I said, you can program the Raspberry Pi Pico using MicroPython. But since I don't know how to code in Python, and I am quite experienced coding for the Arduino, I'm going to use the Arduino language to program the Raspberry Pi Pico. So that's one advantage of the board. You can program it just like you'd program a normal Arduino. So for that, we need to install the board in the Arduino IDE. So this is the Arduino IDE, where we code for the Arduino, and I assume you already know how to use it. If not, I'm going to leave a link here where I explain all the basics of the Arduino, and you can check that out and learn how to use the IDE. So for us to install the board here first, you're gonna go to this link by Erlo Fuhauer. I hope I pronounced this right. And you see that this package implements lots of boards, like the Pi Pico, Pi Pico W, Pi Pico 2, and many other boards. So for you to install this board, you're gonna copy this JSON URL, go to your IDE, go to Settings, and here in Additional Boards Manager URLs, you can press here, And in a new line, if you have all the boards here, just paste this URL. I already have it here, then press OK, then come here to the boards manager. Then type Raspberry Pi, Pi Pico, and install this one by Earl F. Fielhauer. And here, you should have these boards. So since I'm using the Raspberry Pi Pico W, I'm gonna choose this one. But these examples should work with any Raspberry Pi Pico boards. Next, we're gonna plug into the USB, but you need to do something. For you to be able to upload sketches to the board, you need to press this button and then plug into the USB. Now in Tools, here in Port, you should see this UF2 board. If you don't do this, you only see USB port, and that it's only for serial communication. For you to upload the sketch, you need to choose this UF2 board. Now it's a good time to test an example, like the blink example. So this LED built-in here should be enough to find the right LED pin and blink the LED in the board. So let's upload this. So you can see that the LED is blinking, so we should be good to make this board a MIDI controller. So I made a code that sends many different types of MIDI messages using the Raspberry Pi Pico, and they are all in this code, and I left here the link for you to download. You don't need to use anything on the board will only send MIDI messages out, and you can check in a MIDI monitor or on your DAW if it's working. So Gustavo from the future now, and I was recording this video to show you how to use the Adafruit A-Tiny USB library with the MIDI library in order to make the Pico a MIDI controller. Everything were going fine until I tried to make some more complex messages, and it just didn't work well. I was getting invalid messages in my MIDI monitor, so what I did, I wrote a library from scratch. Actually, I didn't write the whole library, I got the A-Tiny USB, and I adapted it to implement MIDI. This way, I could do everything that I wanted with the Pico, writing and reading MIDI. So now I'll show you how to do it. Okay, so the first thing you need to do is go into my GitHub repository, and I'll leave the download link here below. You can come here to code and download zip, and then you can come to your Arduino IDE, sketch, include library, and add zip library. Or you can just drag the folder into your libraries folder. And here in examples, you have MIDI read and MIDI write. Let's open MIDI write. This is a comprehensive example of how you can send different types of messages using the library. So in order to use the library, actually you need to install also the Adafruit Tiny USB library, since this one is based on it. So copy Adafruit Tiny USB, come here to Library Manager, paste, and install the Adafruit Tiny USB library. And you should be good to go. Then you need to initialize the library, typing this, and then give it a name to the instance of the library. Here I just called MIDI. This way it's going to work pretty much the same as the MIDI library. In the setup, you need to call MIDI begin, and here you have the different ways you send different messages. For example, send note on, first it's the note, then the velocity and the channel, note off, control change, which is the CC number, the CC value, and the channel. You have program change, pitch bend, channel pressure, after touch, among other things. Have some fun here. So let's make sure I have the board selected. So let's come here and choose Pi Pico W. Here in port, I'll choose USB modem. And here in USB stack, Adafruit Tiny USB. In order to make it a MIDI controller, we need to choose here in USB stack, Adafruit Tiny USB. And since I'm Gustavo from the future, I also learned another thing. We don't need to unplug the board and plug again pressing the button. We can just press the button and press upload and just release it right after. Let's open MIDI monitor. So you can see here that we have now the Pico W as a MIDI controller, and you can see all the different messages it's sending. So if you are seeing the message correctly here in the MIDI monitor, it means that your MIDI controller is working. And also you have the other example, which is the MIDI read. This is a little bit more advanced, but in case you want to learn it, how to use it, just come here and take a look. Of course, I'm going to leave detailed tutorials inside the Making Music with Arduino course. I'll leave the link here below, and how you can actually use the Pi Pico with my full code, with my extended code, so you can use buttons, potentiometers, rotary encoders, motorized faders, displays, and everything else, just like use the other boards, like the TINC, Arduino, and ESP32. But okay, we have this board sending random MIDI messages. It's kind of useless. You just know that it's sending MIDI message. But what we want to do is actually making a MIDI controller. So now what I want to do is taking a look at the Allegro kit and see what we can come up with any of those sensors. So let's take a look. Okay, so this is the Allegro Raspberry Pi Pico Advanced Kit. It has so many things that I can't even close the lid anymore. So let's take a look. You have this full bag full of sensors, LEDs and buttons and more sensors. You have this car robot, I guess, with motors, wheels, and you have more sensors, and you have breadboards, tiny breadboards. And of course, it comes with the Raspberry Pi Pico W. It says here it comes with 32 sensor modules, 32 MicroPython lessons, and one smart car kit. But we are not MicroPython people, we are Arduino people that like low-level coding, hard to code, easy to suffer, okay? So I was looking on all those sensors and I remembered I wanted to do for a long time, which is a fidget spinner LFO generator. But how can we do that? Well, we can use a sensor called LDR, which is basically a light sensor. I've seen people doing similar things, but with modular synths. I haven't seen a MIDI controller with this kind of device and a fidget spinner, and I'm curious to see how this will sound. So, because we'll be able to use the spin to generate shadows in different ways with the different spinners, and achieve different kinds of LFOs. I think that will be pretty nice. So let's get started. Okay, so here we have our schematic to use our LDR, which is our light sensor, with our Raspberry Pi Pico. So the LDR is this tiny analog sensor that captures the amount of light, and it can be read in one of the analog inputs of your microcontroller. So let's take a brief look here in the Pi Pico pinout. We need to find the analog ports. So this is only three, that's not a lot, but we have here ADC 0, 1, and 2. And also we have this ground for analog sensors. So we need to plug our ground here, and we're going to connect our LDR in the ADC 0, so in pin 31, and the ground is pin 33. So this is our schematic. So one leg of our LDR needs to go to our 3 volts out, so this pin here, and then the other leg you connect to ground through a 10K resistor. So we are connecting here and going to ground, and the same leg goes to the analog port. I'll also leave everything you need here for you to download. Then download the code for the MIDI LDR, and for this you need 2 libraries. One is this one that you already installed, and the other one is the responsive analog read. So let's copy it here and just install this one. This will help to smooth the analog read, because the LDR reading is very noisy, so this will help us a little bit without so much work. I won't get into details, but what this code does is that the LDR will capture the amount of light, and we also have this other button. This button will be used for calibration, so once you press and you hover over the sensor, it will capture the minimum and the maximum values, and this will be mapped into our MIDI range from 0 to 127. So for example, when we have our fidget spinner, we press the button, it will track what is the maximum and the minimum and map our MIDI values accordingly. Okay, so once we have that, let's choose our board, Raspberry Pi Pico W, port USB modem, and USB stack, Adafruit Tiny USB. Then press this button here and press upload. I like to release the button when I see some changes here. Sometimes I don't do that and the code doesn't work, I break the board, so that's what I like doing. Okay, so let's open MIDI monitor. So you can see that the values change. So as I told you, for us to map for the right range, we need to press this button for calibration and then move whatever we need to move here. you'll see that the controller will stop sending values. And now you can see that we change the values when we move it here. So let's see now how it actually sounds.
So now let's see how it works in a musical context with our fidget spinner. And also when we map, I like to first press the calibrate and then go to mapping and then select what we want. Then we're gonna have to calibrate again actually and then release it. So let's see how it sounds. I have a sample loaded. And you can see that different shapes of fidget spinners will give us different sounds because it will give us different patterns of shadows, which I think is pretty cool.
So, what did you think? I had a lot of fun doing this. It's something that I have been wanting to do for a while. I love physics. I have done some things that use physics and MIDI in software, but I haven't done actually using physical things, and I'm planning to do other things and I have some ideas. If you are an artist and you'd like to merge art with technology, physics, and whatever you want through the Arduino, through programming, please take a look here in the Nerd Musician Pro, where I teach you how to make MIDI controllers. MIDI controllers can be used for basically any type of professional that works with art, music, etc. Like DJs, VJs, audio engineers, multimedia artists, people that do video or photo editing, a lot of people. There I teach you how to use my templates, so you don't even need to learn how to code, you don't need to have any experience, but I also have a separate course that I teach you how to code, and also a course where I teach how to do highly professional printed circuit boards. You can purchase the three courses separately or in the bundle called the Nerd Musician Pro. Either way, here in the Nerd Musician Pro link, you can find the bundle or the courses separately. Also, I'll leave the Allegro Advanced Kit here in the description if you want to buy one. So, do you have any crazy idea of something you'd like to build but you don't know yet? Please type here in the comments and maybe I can help you out. Maybe we can build here in the channel. And don't forget to subscribe and give that like. Okay, so see you in the next video. Ciao.